All right, we are back with more interviews as promised. We have two more coming up, so stay tuned with us. And right now we have Mike Faulise. Mike, nice to have you.
Nice to be here.
And Mike, you work for TapQA.
I do.
Yeah, well, work for. I should say you own TapQA.
I do.
Yes.
It's a wonderful thing.
Yeah, so maybe tell us the premise of what made you want to do that or how you started that organization.
Well, TapQA is a consulting services organization. We specialize in testing only because we're here at STAREAST, so why else would we be here at STAREAST? But we really decided in about 2008 that there was a great opportunity for us as an organization to start seeing that we could do jobs as good or better here in the States versus doing it offshore. Mm-hmm. And with the 90s being a big push to push stuff offshore, we decided we wanted to start bringing stuff back, and especially in the testing industry, and do it not only better but faster. Yeah. And at a lower cost, so at the same cost as they are offshoring. And that's how we did it. And so since then, in the last probably 8 years or so, we have brought almost 1,000 jobs back to Minnesota and the States.
Wow, that's so awesome.
Yeah.
That's a great story. So, and I've heard lots of non-traditional folks. So when you look for testers or when you look for people who have potential in that field, I've heard you have some distinct things you look for from a hiring perspective. Can you maybe share some of your tips?
You know, so I'll say that when you look for the right prospective person, you know, normally we'd love to look for an engineer. We'd like to look for somebody that has IT experience,
right,
and or somebody that's got a MIT or a business IT degree. But what we're finding is that those people are really expensive.
Yeah,
because they know they've got a great degree and a great skill set. So
yeah,
what we had to do is figure out if we're going to compete with offshore and with a lot of rates that are much lower, how do we find a great skill set that can test as well, you know, be creative as well as be very, very, very analytical.
Yes.
And so I had to figure out, okay, what skill set can I do? And so that led me down the path of one thing, and that is the starving musician.
Yeah.
So we used people that have music in their backgrounds, and quite frankly, musicians themselves make phenomenal testers. So for you music players out there, for you managers that are looking to hire somebody, find folks with music in their background and they will make phenomenal testers.
Yeah. So kind of that blend of that creative and analytical and
yeah,
that's awesome. That's amazing. Now also in terms of you obviously, you know, work with a lot of companies, place a lot of people. And what are you seeing as the trends, you know, in terms of what people are asking for skill sets? Are you seeing a lot of automation, more manual? Where is that kind of going in your world?
Yeah, you know, I'd say that there's kind of three bubbles, if I could visualize bubbles for the audience. There's the, I got to have QA skill sets, I got to have business knowledge, and
yep,
I got to have technical knowledge. And if you got all three of those, you're always going to have a job.
Yep.
But most people have two of the three.
Yeah.
And so what we found in the previous world is that I always wanted somebody that had QA but knew my industry.
Yeah.
And what we're finding is that now knowing my industry may not be that important. And so the trend has been I want somebody that knows QA and technology.
Yeah.
And so we're seeing more things along that trend in line.
Yeah. So for folks out there that are watching that say, hey, this, you know, that's really great advice now, you know, both from the hiring manager side of what to look for as well as skill sets. Any recommendations or advice for people that are saying, you know, I'm not technical and I want to get more technical, or things that, you know, you would suggest they do to kind of brush up those types of skill sets?
Sure. You know, I talked about this in one of my presentations. I think that if you're a non-technical person and you're a little afraid of code, you know, one of the things you can do is to actually take a music class. And to say, you know what, you're interested in learning the piano or maybe the guitar or whatever
yeah,
it might be, go see if you can go do that. And you don't have to spend thousands of hours on it, but go
right,
take a class or two and say, you know what, if you can start to pick that up, it's amazing the translation between picking up an instrument and then actually starting to learn how to code. And they're very similar.
Yeah.
So start there. And it's a great place to say, you know what, if I really can't do this, then maybe coding is going to be much more challenging.
Yeah.
But if you can try it and you like it, there is a lot of parallels.
Oh, that's awesome. So another great tip just on what to do if you're trying to get more technical. Also, there may be some leaders or managers out there who are saying, I'm struggling with this new generation that just Googles everything, right? I just want to Google to get the answer.
Sure.
Obviously, you do a lot of hiring and have a lot of new young talent and folks that come into the organization. Anything in particular that you try and do with those folks to get them out of that box of just, I can Google everything and learning how to actually think again?
Yeah, you know, it's hard because you can Google everything.
Yeah.
So what we find is we are looking for definitely problem solvers.
Yes.
So what we'll do is, you know, part of what we want to be able to do is that both creative as well as analytical skills,
mm-hmm,
we love people that can tell a story.
Yeah.
And so that storytelling has been great and a great asset for folks that really have to understand how to solve a problem.
Yep.
And sometimes in the consulting world, as I'm sure many of you guys know, you have to be able to talk to people, and communication is the key. So I think what we find is another skill set that we look for is people that have had serving in their background,
yep,
or that they've bartended. These are folks that definitely know how to communicate. And
yeah,
that's really where the problem solving comes in, because the technical stuff, while it's hard, you can get by.
Yeah, but being able to relate cross-generational is important, it sounds like, and
absolutely,
having that capability to do that. So some good tips and advice. If people want more information, that you maybe probably intrigue them on, you know, things about TapQA, others, how do they find you? How do they get more information?
TapQA.com is where to go. We've got an info@TapQA for an email. Otherwise, you can find us on the StAREAST website as well.
Perfect. Thanks, Mike, for being here.
Yeah, thank you.
I appreciate it. Stay tuned. Another interview coming up next.